Welcome to this complete tutorial of the VC-1-DMX Video Lighting Converter. The VC-1-DMX is a unique, compact solution, allowing a user to generate custom lighting programming using video content. In this video, you'll learn how to connect the VC-1-DMX to your light fixtures, set up your fixtures for DMX control, set up a DMX map in the VC-1-DMX software, how to convert MIDI to DMX, how to use audio to have fixtures flash to the beat, along with some tips to get the best results. The VC-1-DMX lets each color on a fixture choose part or all of the video image to match. So if you have fixtures on opposite sides of the room, you can have one analyze the left half of the video image and the other analyze the right. Here's a clear example of this. The video background is black, and as a red line moves from left to right, the light reacts to the change. And here it is with the green line. So, as you position your lights, think about how you want them to react to video content. In this tutorial, we will use 10 total fixtures, 5 bars, 4 pars, and a mirror ball. To begin setup, connect your fixtures to the 3-pin and/or 5-pin DMX outputs of the VC-1-DMX. Both outputs are active and carry the same signal. You need to link all the fixtures to the VC-1-DMX using DMX cables in any order. Each fixture will have a DMX input and output. Make sure to use cables that are specifically rated for DMX signals. 3-pin XLR microphone cables will work, but may cause issues with larger setups. It's also recommended to have a DMX terminator connected to the DMX output of the final fixture in the signal chain. These look like connectors with no cable. Next, connect a computer or media player to the HDMI input and play a video clip on loop. Connect the HDMI output to your display. Note that any audio on the HDMI input will pass through to the HDMI output. You can also use the MIDI and RCA audio inputs for control. We will cover those later in this tutorial. By now, you have your cables connected and your lighting setup planned out, so you're ready to connect the VC-1-DMX to its software to configure your DMX map. First, download and install the VC-1-DMX tool software from the Roland website. Go to the VC-1-DMX product page and click on the Downloads tab, and you will see it on the list. The software is available for both Windows and Mac OS. Once installed, power on the VC-1-DMX by connecting the AC adapter, connect the USB 2.0 cable between the VC-1-DMX and computer, open the software, and click the Connect button in the top left corner. If you need to resize the software window, use the Zoom menu along the top. Once connected, if the firmware on your VC-1-DMX is not up to date, the software will ask if you want to automatically update. When the update is complete, it will ask you to unplug the VC-1-DMX and plug it in again to restart. Once you do that, reopen the software and connect again. The VC-1-DMX supports a single DMX universe, which is a group of 512 channels. Before we start, we should erase this default map by clicking on channel 1, holding the Shift key and clicking on channel 512, and then clicking the clear button. Let's set up our first light fixture using this LED bar. Open the fixture's manual and look for two things: how to set the fixture to DMX mode, and the charts that contain the DMX channel mode information. We will need this chart to set up the fixture in the software. It's helpful to sketch this out beforehand to determine how many DMX channels you will need for your setup and what the starting channel, commonly known as address, is for each fixture. Let's set up our first fixture. We'll start with this LED bar. Some fixtures may only have one lighting mode, and some, like this one, have 7 to choose from. For this setup, we chose the 10-channel mode for this LED bar, and since there are 5 of them in our setup, they will use 50 of our 512 channels. It's recommended to give each fixture its own address, because one of the advantages of the VC-1-DMX is that each fixture can analyze a different area of the video image and make your lighting setup more dynamic. Using the fixtures manual, I see that the first four channels are red, green, blue, and amber, so I will set that up in the software. Note that there are 8 colors available depending on the capabilities of your fixture. Click on channel 1, and then click on the data type drop-down menu and select red. Next, click on the data area drop-down menu and select column, and confirm column 1 is selected below it. The data area setting chooses which part of the video image you want to extract the color from. If you choose the whole screen, the VC-1-DMX will take the entire video image and decide what the average color is. Since we have multiple fixtures to work with, we will set them up to decide the color based on a smaller section of the video image, making the setup more dynamic. The ratio slider below data area reduces the intensity of that color on that fixture. This can be helpful when trying to balance colors in a space with a particular fixture. Try different styles of video content to confirm the change is an improvement. Now that channel 1 is finished, we can set up channels 2 through 4 with green, blue, and amber, all on column 1. Channels 5 through 8 are the same colors again because 10 channel mode on this fixture splits control of the left and right halves of the LED bar. Instead of manually entering those color settings again, here is a trick to save time. Make sure the area index increment box is checked and the value is 1. Click on channel 1 and shift-click channel 4 to select them all. Click copy, click on channel 5, and click paste. When you click on channel 5, you will see it is on column 2 because area index increment adjusts it, making this a helpful tool to save time during setup. Now that we set up our colors, channel 9 will be a fixed value of 0, and channel 10 is master dimmer. Fixed value sends a control value between 0 and 255. It has many uses, but a good example is controlling a fixture's strobe mode. In the fixture's manual, you will see detailed information on how it reacts to the range of values. Because we do not want to use this fixture's strobe mode yet, we will leave the value at 0. The master dimmer data type cannot be adjusted. It instead follows the master dimmer slider, located in the real-time parameter section on the left side of the main screen. This slider controls the brightness of all fixtures when all color is checked. If you uncheck it, then the master dimmer only affects fixtures that have the master dimmer data type set up. Here's an example of both ways to use the master dimmer slider. If you do not want a fixture to be affected, change its master dimmer data type to a fixed value of 255. There are also 2 settings for external MIDI control, as well as rotate speed, which controls fixtures with motors when using B-flash audio control, like this mirror ball. We will cover these 3 data types later in this tutorial. Assuming the fixture is set to DMX mode and the address is 1, it's ready to go. Let's set up our next light. With area index increment still checked, change the value from 1 to 2. Copy channels 1 through 10 and paste on channel 17 to better organize your layout, since we're not using all 512 channels. Note how channel 17 is column 3 and channel 21 is column 4. You just set up your second fixture in seconds. With the LED bars set up, we can move on to the par fixtures. These cannot be split like the bars, so the color information affects the entire fixture, but this model supports more colors. We chose 8 channel mode for this fixture, and since there are 4 of them, they will use 32 channels. We will also use the split 4 data area instead of column, so each fixture will analyze a quarter of the video image. Starting with channel 97, we will set up the color channels as red, green, blue, white, amber, and purple. These are followed by master dimmer and a fixed value for strobe mode. On this fixture, the LEDs turn off if the fixed value is 0 for strobe mode, so I need to change it to 32 to turn them on. Now that I set up this first par, I copy channels 97 through 104 with area index increment enabled and set to 1. Click on channel 113 and click paste. We can then click copy, click on channel 129 and paste again, repeating this until all the PAR fixtures are set up. Finally, we will set up the mirror ball, which is set to analyze the whole video image instead of a section. We chose 9-channel mode for this fixture. Starting with channel 177, the first three channels will be red, green, and blue. You may have seen on the data type list, pickup 3 color and 4 color. The pickup modes are another way to analyze color in a video source. The 3 color mode extracts the strongest color between red, green, and blue, with no colors in between, and 4 color mode adds white. Because the mirror ball will use the whole data area, we will set up red, green, and blue as pickup 3 color. The color channels are followed by strobe mode, master dimmer, motor control, and some additional modes we will not use, so we will give the last two channels a fixed value of 0. The motor can be controlled by the rotation speed data type, which allows you to control the speed using beat flash synchronized to an audio input, which we will cover later. Now that we covered the DMX channel settings and set up our fixtures, let's go through some additional settings. Along the top, the file menu gives you options to import and export your DMX maps. Although the VC-1-DMX is a single universe, you can store up to 4 DMX maps in it, which are accessed using setting switches 3 and 4 on the converter. This is helpful if you have alternate configurations you want to use for different types of events without having to connect the software. That's because the VC-1-DMX does not need the software to run. Once you set up your DMX maps, you're ready to go. If you want to use additional DMX maps or back up a map before you edit it, you can use the file menu to manage your map files on your computer. This can be helpful if you want to experiment with settings. Throughout this tutorial, we mentioned some of the setting switches on the VC-1-DMX hardware. You will notice that the lower left corner of the main screen shows you what each one is set to. Note that the switches cannot be adjusted using the software. They are displayed for reference and need to be changed on the VC-1-DMX itself. As you adjust the switch, the change will reflect in the software. But you can also use these switches without the software. The advanced menu gives you options to adjust settings that affect the overall operation of the VC-1-DMX. The color range setting adjusts the VC-1-DMX to match the video source's color space. If you're not sure what it is, you don't need to adjust this, as it may incorrectly process the color information from your video source. Color gain boosts the colors in all your fixtures if needed. Master dimmer and tempo set the default values for these controls when you power on the VC-1-DMX. The controls for master dimmer and tempo are in the real-time parameters section of the main screen. No sound operation turns off all the fixtures when there is no audio input. You can enable it by turning on setting switch 8. Threshold adjusts the audio level that is considered silent. Any audio below that level will turn off all the fixtures. Judge time adds a delay in milliseconds before the fixtures turn off. The DMX channel settings let you choose a specific range of channels that are affected by no sound operation, which is useful for keeping some fixtures on. We will cover the beat flash and MIDI settings in the next two sections of this tutorial. Along the right, you can see what the incoming video signal's format is, the firmware version on the VC-1-DMX, as well as backup, restore, or reset your settings. There are two additional ways to control your fixtures with the VC-1-DMX. First, we will cover MIDI. Going back to the list of data types, MIDI note lets you use keys and pads to control a channel on a fixture with on and off signals. And MIDI CC is typically used with knobs and sliders to set the value for the DMX channel. Note that the VC-1-DMX still requires an HDMI video signal to output DMX signals. If you only want to use it for MIDI or audio control, output blank video from a laptop or HDMI splitter. For this example, we will use the MC-707, which can play MIDI notes using its pads, plus send MIDI CC with its knobs. Using MIDI to control your DMX channels will override the HDMI signal for that channel. Going back to our DMX map, we're going to change some of the color channels to MIDI. On this PAR fixture, I will click on channel 97, click data type, and choose MIDI note. Next, I will find the MIDI note number the pad is sending. You can usually find MIDI note and CC numbers in the device's menu or manual. I will then adjust channel 97's MIDI channel and note number settings to match the device. When I press the pad we set up, the PAR fixture turns red until I let go. In the advanced settings, note release time sets how long the fixture stays on and fades out after a MIDI note is turned off. Once I change a few color channels to MIDI note control for each PAR fixture, I can control them with a live performance on the device. Let's now set up a knob to control MIDI CC, also known as control change. Click on the fixed value channel to control strobe for that bar fixture, and change the data type to MIDI CC. Now, I need to find the CC number of the knob I want to use on the device. I will then set the DMX channel to that CC number. I will also adjust the MIDI offset and gain settings if needed. MIDI values range from 0 to 127, and DMX values 0 to 255. The MIDI offset setting adds 128 to the MIDI value, and gain doubles it. With everything set up, when I adjust this knob, the bar fixture strobe control is adjusted. Another way to use MIDI CC is to control the master dimmer slider in the real-time parameters section. You can set it up in the advanced settings. In the MIDI section, set the master dimmer control channel to match the device, and CC number to match the knob you want to use. Note that if the all color box is checked, it's a global dimmer adjustment. If unchecked, the VC-1-DMX only affects the fixtures with master dimmer channels assigned. Next, we will set up audio control. You can use either RCA and/or HDMI audio input and mix their levels in the software, and the VC-1-DMX will automatically detect the tempo of any music. This tempo can be used with beat flash, which flashes the lights in sync with the music, as well as the rotate speed data type. To use beat flash, you also need to turn up the analog output slider in the software, even if nothing is connected to the RCA outputs. Note that the HDMI output does not carry the audio mix. It only passes through the HDMI input audio without any level adjustment. To set up beat flash mode, turn on setting switch 5 on the VC-1-DMX. Setting switch 6 is optional. Turning it on will increase the brightness of the flash. And if you turn on switch 7, the beat flash color is automatic, but we will leave it off. Next, make sure that the auto audio box is checked in the real-time parameter settings. If it is unchecked, you can set a manual tempo to use. Choose which audio input you want to use, RCA or HDMI, and turn down the other in the software's audio mixer. Next, play some music to test beat flash. You will soon see the fixtures flash to the tempo of the music. If you go back to the advanced settings, you can change the amount of red, green, and blue in the beat flash color. Remember that if more than one slider is up, it will combine them into a different flash color. Additionally, the tempo will affect channels with the rotate speed data type, like our mirror ball. For that channel, we have the speed range set up based on the fixture's manual, so the tempo can control the speed, making it faster or slower as the songs change. You can also use this to control the speed of strobe mode on a fixture. Now that everything is set up, here's a short demo of the VC-1-DMX in action. That concludes our VC-1-DMX tutorial. We hope that you are now more familiar with how to use and take advantage of the features offered by VC-1-DMX. For more information, please visit proav.roland.com.